Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar. In this video, you will learn how to use Spotlight visualization in Excel. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created these three spotlights, red, amber, green color. These are my KPI metrics like service level, quality score and sales conversion. And this is the color coding. If it will be below 50%, then it will show in red. 50 to 80 it will be in yellow, and above 80 it will be in green. So let me show you for the service level first. It is 45%, that is the reason it is in red color. If I will change it as, let's say, 55%, then it will be yellow, because 50 to 80 it will be in yellow. If I will take 75, then still it will be in yellow. Change it as 85, then it will be in green color. So these spotlight color will be changed according to data. You can use this in your business dashboard or business presentation. This video will be in two parts. The first part will be the red spotlight, and the second part will be the, you can highlight your team manager by sales. Let's say we have four team managers here, and these are the sales number. I have put the random number here and between formula. Whoever has made the highest sale, that will be highlighted. Spotlight will be switched on. You can see, if I will recalculate this, then you can see now Prince is highlighted and now PK is highlighted because this is the maximum sale. Alright, so you can use this chart also to display just your team sales or your team's productivity. So this chart is in two parts. One is this part 2A, which is simple chart, and the second is you can create this beautiful floor and you can place this chart here. If I will calculate worksheet, then you can see whoever is making the highest sale will be highlighted. Alright friends, so you will learn in the next part of this video these two charts. In this video I will explain you this chart. So let's start. I'm going to add a new workbook here. I'll press Ctrl N. So this is the new workbook, book 3, and here I will copy this data, paste this here, and I'm also going to copy this data. I will put this data here. Let me remove the grid lines from the worksheet first. So I'll go to the view and I will uncheck the grid lines. Alright, here I will put a formula, the simple if formula. I'll put if the service level value is less than 50%, then it will be red. And again I will put if, and then I will put and formula because I need two conditions. If this value is greater than or equal to 50%, and the second condition, this value is less than or equal to 80%, then it will be yellow. Otherwise this value will be green. Enter. Fill the same formula, or if you have the different logic to your matrix, you can use the different formula also, and just fill this down. Now here it will give the color, like it should be green or it should be yellow or it should be red. Now here I'm just putting the rand between formula just for the timing. Let's say 20 to 99%. Here you can put the percentage sign. So it will give you the random number. You can see it will change according to this number. Now I'll create a spotlight first. So I'll create the spotlight using the Excel auto save. So I'll go to the insert, save. I will take this oval from the basic saves. Just click here. So this oval is created. You can change the size, take around this size, make the duplicate of this. So just select this and press Ctrl D, or you can press Ctrl C and Ctrl V. So I have made the duplicate of this. Now we have two ovals. We will select both the ovals, go to the format, align this center, then align this middle. Alright, so just click outside somewhere. Now I will select only one oval, and then I will press Ctrl Shift, and I will change the size. So I will reduce the size. I'll take around this size. Alright, so we have two ovals. The first is the bigger one and the second is little smaller. So now I will select small oval first, then I will go to the format, and here I will take the shape outline as no outline, and the shape fill I'll take, let's say, this yellow one. Now I will select this bigger oval, right click, go to the format shape. Now I'll go to the fill, and here I will select the gradient fill. So this is some default gradient is available. Go to the preset gradient, and here I will select this gradient, the first one. Now I will change the color of this gradient. So I'll select the first stop and here I will choose this white color. For the second one, I'll choose some dark gray color. Let's say this one and then this. Again, slightly darker, this one. And we can remove the shape outline also. Just take no outline. So our shape will look like this. Now I will select both the shapes, right click and make this group. Now in this group, I'll go to the effects and I will select only the bigger circle in this group. Double click on this and then go to the 3D format. And here I will choose some bevel. So I'll take this one, which is convex, and I'll give some depth also. I'll take around 20-25. Now I'll change the preset of this. So first of all, I'll select the entire group, just click outside anywhere and then select it again. All right, because we have selected just bigger circle, now we have selected entire group. So I'll go to the 3D rotation here and I'll go to the preset and I will select this preset offset axis one. So this shape will look like this. You can change the size if you want. Now I will go to the insert and I will insert another shape and I will take this shape from the basic shape, which is the trapezoid. Click here and just click here. Now I'll go to the format, rotate, and I will rotate this as flip vertical. And I will keep this shape here, change the size like this. Now I will select this shape, I'll go to the shape outline, will choose no outline, and then I'll go to the fill and line here and I will select the gradient fill. In the gradient fill, I'll change the position of the stops. I'll keep four stops. First one should be on 0, second one should be on 33%, and then I'll keep third one as 66 and the last on 100%. Now I will change the color for each stop. I'll take the same yellow color. Okay, now I will put some transparency. For the first stop, I'll put here 40% transparent. For the second one, I'll put here 60%, and the third one I'll put here 80%, and the last one I'll put 100%. All right, so our shape will look like this. Now it is looking like a spotlight. So I will select these two groups, right click and make it a final group. Now this is a shape. Now quickly I will make this duplicate, just press Ctrl D, and I will make another copy of this, just press Ctrl D. For the second one we can keep yellow, and for the first one we will keep red, and the last one we will keep as green. So for the first one I will select this small oval first, just double click here in this group, and you can see it is showing as solid fill yellow. In place of this I'll take red. And then I will change the color of this. So we will keep the same gradient, but only thing is we will take the red color. So I'm quickly filling the red color and I'll fill the same transparency. First one is 40, second one is 60, third one is 80 and last one 100. So I'm quickly doing this activity. Okay, so I have created this red spotlight. Similarly, I'll create the green spotlight. I'll select first this oval and I'll change this light green color. And I will fill the same color in focus also. So I'll fill the green color quickly. Alright, so we have created all three lights. Now I will create a new worksheet here. I will rename this worksheet as support and I will resize the row and column like this. Cut these three shapes, just press Ctrl X, go to the support sheet and paste this here. I will move the first one here. First of all, just select all the shapes, right click, go to the size and properties, and here go to the properties, just select this don't move or size with cells. Now we will copy this cell and select these two and just paste a special column width. So the same column width will be applied here, and now put this yellow one here. If you want to give some shadow here, so you can select this bigger circle and go to the format, then go to the shape effect shadow, and you can select this one which is offset center. Small shadow is available here. If you want to format this, you can go to the shadows from here and you can change the size around 105 or 6%. It will look like this. Same thing you can do for the other. All right, so we have all three shapes here. Now what I will do, I will copy this cell which is A1, just copy this, go to the sheet 1 and just go to the home tab and paste here. I will go to the paste special, the other option. You can see this option which is linked picture. So we have a linked picture here. Now I'll go to the support sheet and here I will go to the view. I'll remove the grid lines from here. I will create few names. A1 is for red. So what I will do, I'll go to the name manager in the formulas, name manager. I'll create a name and this will be for red. That will be support A1. Then I will create the new name for yellow. And here I will take this reference which is V1. Then I will create for green and this time I will take this reference which is C1. Just close this. I'll go to the sheet 1 again. Here I will create the few name for service label quality score and sales conversion. So what I will do here, I'll go to the name manager again. I'll create a new name and this will be for service label. And for the service label, I'll use indirect. From the support sheet we have created the name with the same spelling like yellow, green and red, so we can use the indirect formula here. For the service label we will use indirect and then we can give this reference sheet 1 range C1. And similarly for a quality score, again I will use indirect, then I will take this reference, let's close, new, and here I will take sales conversion, indirect and range I will take this one. We can make the 3 copy of this. Select the shape and press Ctrl D. So we have 3 copies here. Select all 3 shapes first, then align top, distribute horizontally. For the first one here, go to the formula bar and type as service label, the name which we have created. This will be for service label. Service label is in yellow, you can see. And now here I will type, this will be for quality score, equal to quality score, enter. And here I will type equal to sales conversion, enter. Whatever color is available here, it will be displayed here accordingly. If I will recalculate this, then you can see the color is getting changed. Now you can simply insert a text box or a simple word art from here. Let's say I'm taking this one. Quickly I will select this shape and go to the format, press equal to and take service label from here. Change the color as white, font color white, bold, slightly bigger. Keep this here, make a copy of this, keep this here, another copy, just keep this here. This will be your quality score and this will be your sales conversion. And now select the first one. We will put the same format. Double click on the format printer, just click here, click here. All right, you can change the size according to requirement. Now we will create the label like we have created here. So we can make the copy of this, just copy and paste. We will keep this here and now this time we will connect with this one. Service label value, size around 45 or 50. Font name, take agency AP, make this bold. Go to the format, font color we will take this one, and then shape outline we will take no outline. We'll go to the shape effect, shadow should be no shadow. Then I'll go to the bevel and I will take this bevel, this one angle, and then I will go to the 3D rotation and I'll take this one. Alright, so it will look like this. Now just make a copy of this, just press Ctrl D, keep this here, Ctrl D, and just keep this here. For the second one we will connect it with the B2, and for this we will connect it with the this one. Now select the first one, go to the home, format printer, double click and just click here and just click here. Now if I will recalculate this, you can see it is getting changed. So friends, that is how you can create the spotlights with red, amber and green colors. And now in the next part of this video you will see these 2 charts, how can you create. Please watch the next part of this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Thank you so much for watching.